My dear students, good evening everybody. Then today I would like to give some idea about Pythagoras theorem and solving problems involving Pythagoras theorem. Then okay, before this time, you have learned something about Pythagoras theorem when you were in grade 9. Actually, I know you have learned about Pythagoras theorem and usage of Pythagoras theorem. First of all, I would like to draw here three types of triangles. We can name them as ABC, DEF, and PQR. ABC is an acute angle triangle, DEF is a right angle triangle, and PQR is an obtuse angle triangle. Out of these three triangles, Pythagoras theorem can be used for only right angled triangles. Right, okay. Then, what is the Pythagoras theorem? The area of the square drawn on hypotenuse of any right angle triangle is equal to the sum of the areas of two squares drawn on sides containing right angle. That means if this triangle is ABC and angle B is angle with 90 degrees, Pythagoras theorem can be used for this one. I am going to draw here squares on three sides of the right angle triangle ABC. Right. Just now I have drawn three squares on three sides of this right angle triangle ABC. This is the square drawn on hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. They are the squares drawn on two sides containing right angle. If the area of the square drawn on side AC is X, and the area of the square drawn on side AB is Y, and The area of the square drawn on side BC is, is it? We can build up a relationship by using x, y and z. According to the Pythagoras theorem, x equals the sum of y and z. Y and z. How to get the, how to find the area of the square drawn on side AC? When getting the square of a side of any square, there can be obtained the area of that relevant square. The length of a side of this square can be indicated by the length of AC. Then that can be written as AC squared. What is AC squared? That is the area of the square drawn on side AC. That's equal. The area of the square drawn on side AB, that can be obtained by getting the square of side AB. Then that is AB squared. Plus, the area of the square drawn on side BC can be obtained by getting the square of side BC. Then that is BC square. Then, the area of the square drawn on the hypotenuse can be represented by AC square. The area of the square drawn on side AB can be represented by AB squared, and the area of the square drawn on side BC can be represented as BC squared. Then AC squared equals AB squared plus BC squared. This is the, now we can say the Pythagoras theorem. What is the Pythagoras theorem? You can write it like this. In a right angle triangle, the area of the square, drawn on the hypotenuse, is equal to the sum of the areas of the squares drawn on the remaining sides of the triangle which include the right angle that is the Pythagoras theorem. Who is Pythagoras? He was a great mathematician. Was born in Greece, right? Then okay. Now I am going to focus my attention to a triangle, right angle triangle. Let's consider the name of this right angle triangle is ABC. In which angle B is 90 degrees. The area of the square drawn on side AC can be represented by AC squared. The area of the square drawn on side AB can be represented by AB squared. Then the area of the square drawn on side BC can be represented by BC squared. Then what is the Pythagoras relation? The area of the square drawn on hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the areas of two squares drawn on other two sides. Then AC squared, that's equal AB squared plus BC squared. Okay. Then if the length of side AB is 6 cm and if the length of side BC is if the length of side AB is 8 cm and length of the side BC is 6 cm, then how to use the Pythagoras relation to find the length of AC? Then according to this relationship, we can write here, therefore AC squared equals 8 squared plus 6 squared. Then AC squared equals 64 plus 36. Therefore AC squared equals 100. Then AC equals root 100, that is 10 centimeter. Now we can say the length of AC equals 10 centimeter. Right. Then when given the two sides of any rectangle triangle, we can find the length of remaining side by using the Pythagoras relation. I think that is the importance can be seen of this Pythagoras relation. Right, okay, now I am going to draw here another right angle triangle. Which it is PQR, then Q is the right angle of this right angle triangle. Then if the length of side PQ is 13 cm and length of QR is 5 cm, then how to use the Pythagoras relation to find the length of side PQ? Then here we can write there PQ squared equals PR squared minus QR squared. Okay, let's see it. PQ squared equals PR squared minus QR squared. If PR squared equal to the sum of QR squared and PQ squared, we can write here PQ squared equals PR squared minus QR squared. Therefore, PQ squared equal 13 squared minus 5 squared. PQ squared equals 169 minus 25. Therefore, PQ squared equals 144. 144 is a perfect square number, real square root for this value. Therefore, PQ equals 12 cm, that is the length of side PQ. Then, I am going to remember the previous one again. When given the two sides of any right angle triangle, to find the length of remaining side, we can use the Pythagoras relation. That is very important subject matter, right? Then, what about the proof of this Pythagoras theorem? That proof is not included in new syllabus. Included in this syllabus. Okay, right? Then you have to, you should have known the usage of Pythagoras relation. Therefore, focus my attention to unit number exercise 17.1. I am going to focus my attention to exercise 17.1. Right? Turn to the page number 6. Right. The first one of exercise 17.1. What is it? Fill in the blanks using the information in the figure. In first figure, we can see here right angle triangle in which MNO. What is the name of this right angle triangle? That is MNO. Then MO squared. What is MO squared? That is the area of the square drawn on drawn on the hyperareas. Then M O squared equals M N squared plus O N squared. That can be written in the two blanks. Then second one. There are three right angle triangles here. First one is ABD, that is also right angle triangle because angle BAD is 90 degrees. That is given as 90 degrees. Then we can identify the triangle ABD as a right angle triangle. Now you see here that line AC is drawn to BT perpendicularly. Therefore, ABC and ACD are pair of right angle triangles. So AC is perpendicular to BD. Then BD squared. You see BD squared. Then BD is the hypotenuse of the right angle triangle ABD. Therefore, BD squared equals AD squared plus AD squared. Am I correct? Then okay, then blank, some blank space is there in second step. That's equal AC squared plus CD squared. Then side AC and side CD, both sides can be seen of the triangle ACD. Then what is the hypotenuse of the right angle triangle ACD? That is AD. Then therefore we can write the AD squared equals AC squared equals CD squared. Then okay, the last step is AB squared equals AC squared plus blank space. Then a side AB and side AC can be seen of the right angle triangle ABC. Therefore, AB squared equals AC squared plus BC squared. Then BC squared should be written on the blank space. Now we have third one. There is a quadrilateral. The name of this quadrilateral is PQRS. The two diagonals intersect at T, and that lines are perpendicular to each other. That means two diagonals are intersected at point T perpendicularly. Then okay, PQ squared can be seen of the right angle triangle PQD. Therefore, PQ squared equals PT squared plus QT squared. Am I correct? Then here, on the other hand, let's see QR squared. Then QR can be seen of the right angle triangle QTR. Therefore, QR squared equals QT squared plus TR squared. Then okay, finally, we can see that fourth figure. In the fourth figure, there are three right angle triangles. What are they? Line AC is drawn to BD perpendicularly. After that we can see here, we can identify there two right angle triangles like ABC and ACD. On the other hand, line CE is drawn to AD perpendicularly. Then there also can be seen another two right angle triangles. Then they are ACE and CED. Then how many right angle triangles can be seen of this figure? I think there are four right angle triangles. What are they? ABC, ACD, ACE and CDE. All of them are right angle triangles. Okay. Now we have to fill the blank spaces of that given steps by using the Pythagoras relation to these triangles. Then first one, AB squared equals blank space plus AC squared. Then here the sides AB and AC, the sides AB and AC can be seen of the right angle triangle ABC. Therefore, AB squared equals BC squared plus AC squared. Then what is the second step? Started from a blank space. That's equal to AE squared plus EC squared. AE squared plus EC squared. Now let's consider the right angle triangle ACE. Therefore, AC squared equals AE squared plus EC squared. Right? Then finally, AD squared equals AC squared plus with blank space. Then side AD and AC can be seen of the right angle triangle ACD. Therefore, AD square equals AC square plus CD square. Then second one, find the value of x in each of the right angle triangles given below. Now I am going to draw that diagrams on the board, and I would like to get the value for x. First one is triangle ABC. In the triangle ABC, C is the right angle. That is marked here. Then the length of the side AC is 6 centimeter. The length of side BC is 8 centimeter. The length of side AB is represented by S. Then what is our duty? What is our task? Getting the value for X. Then X square equals 6 square plus 8 square. Am I correct? That is the usage of the Pythagoras theorem. X square equals 6 square plus 8 square. Therefore, x squared equals 36 plus 64. When adding them, after that they are will be 100. If x squared equal 100, what is the value of x? The square root of 100. By getting the square root of 100, we can get the length for x. Therefore, x equals square root 100. That's equal 10 centimeter. Now we can say the length of the side AB of the right angle triangle ABC is 10 cm. Now let's consider the next right angle triangle. This is the right angle of it. That triangle is named as PQR. The length of PQ is 12 cm and QR is 13 cm. That PR is represented by X. Then our duty is getting the value for X. Then x squared equals 13 squared minus 12 squared. 13 squared minus 12 squared. Is it the Pythagoras theorem? No. That is not the Pythagoras theorem. That is only usage of Pythagoras relationship. Therefore, x squared equals 13 squared is 169 minus 12 squared is 144. Therefore, x squared equals 25, then x equals root 25. Real square root is there, that is 5 centimeter. The length of x is 5 centimeter. Then I am going to focus my attention to third one. Right. KLN is a triangle. I think that is not a right angle triangle. This is the shape of the triangle KLN. KM is perpendicular to LN. KM is perpendicular to LN. The length of KL is root 5 cm. Length of LN is root 2 cm. Length of MN is given as 1 cm. KM represented by X. Right. Then here, the Pythagoras relation should be used for the triangle KLM to get the length for KM. Right. What is the usage of Pythagoras theorem? Then KM squared equals root 5 squared minus root 2 squared. Because we need to get the length of KM. Then KM squared equals, do you know the root 5 squared? When getting the root 5 squared, root 5 has to be multiplied by with root 5 again. When multiplying root 5 by root 5, then also will be root 25. 25 has a real square root, that is 5. Then root 5 squared is 5 minus root 2 squared is 2. Similarly, you can get the value of root 2 squared, that is 2. Then KM squared equals 3. Is it a perfect square number? Really, that is not a perfect square number. Then the length of KM can be obtained as a root. that valley, very sorry, then the length of km can be expressed as a third. The root 3 is a third because 3 hasn't real square root. Then that square root of 3 is root 3, that is a third. I think that in first lesson already you have learnt about thirds in unit real numbers. There are two types of numbers. Some of them are irrational numbers, others are irrational numbers. Then root 3 is an irrational number. Right, okay. In the right angle triangle KM, two sides are known. Length of KM is root 3 and MN is root 3. How to find the length of X? By using the Pythagoras relation. The usage of the Pythagoras relation is X squared, that's equal root 3 squared plus 1 squared. Therefore, X squared equals, do you know the value of root 3 squared? Root 3 times of root 3 is 3. 3 plus 1 squared is 1. Therefore, x squared equals 4. This value has a real square root. Then what is the square root of 4? Therefore, x equals root 4. The value of root 4 is 2. Then the length of x is length of km is represented by x. The value of x is 2 centimeters. Value of x is 2 centimeters. Okay. Finally, we have to focus our attention to fourth figure in second column. Right, okay. Now I am going to draw the given diagram. This triangle named as PQR. PQR. The right angle is here. Angle QPR is a right angle. Then here another right angle triangle is here. Angle POR is 90 degrees. Now we can see here there are two right angle triangles. PQR and POR. Both of them are right angle triangles. Then here, this line is represented by 12, this line is, the length of this line is 12 centimeter, the length of this side is x, and that is 3 centimeter, and OR is 4 centimeter. Right. Then our task is getting the value for X by using the Pythagoras relation. First of all, I am going to use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle BOR. Then what is the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle? The opposite side to right angle is PR. Therefore, PR squared equals PU squared plus OR squared. PR squared equal PU squared plus OR squared. Then PR squared equals 3 squared plus OR squared is 4 squared. Therefore, PR squared equals 9 plus 16. Therefore, PR squared equals 25. Then how we get the value for PR? Therefore, PR equals square root of 25. That is 5 centimeter. Then the length of PR is 5 centimeter. Then in the right angle triangle PQR, two sides are known. Length of VR is 5 cm and length of PQ is 12 cm. Then what is the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle? That is the opposite side to the right angle, that is QR. Then we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle PQR again. Then QR squared equals 12 squared plus 5 squared. Therefore, QR squared equals 144 plus 25. Then QR squared equals 169. Therefore, QR equals square root of 169. Then QR equals 13 centimeters. QR equals 13 centimeters. That is the length of QR. Okay, Buddha. Now, we have obtained the values for PR and QR. But we need the length of X. Therefore, X equals 13 centimeter. X equals 13 centimeter. Okay? Did you understand something? Yes. Let's focus to third one. Some statement is given there. What is it? In the equilateral triangle ABC, what is ABC? That is an equilateral triangle. If it is an equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal to each other. In the triangle ABC, AB equals AC, that's equal BC. All the sides are equal to each other. D is the foot of the perpendicular drawn from the vertex A to the side BC. Then AD is a perpendicular line. AD is the perpendicular line drawn to BC from the vertex A. Then after that, we can identify here two right angle triangles. First one is ABD, next one is ACD. Then ABD and ACD are pair of right angle triangles. If the length of a side of the triangle is 2 cm, now what is the length of a side of the equilateral triangle? Each side is 2 cm. Find the length of AD. Find the length of AD. Right. Okay. What is AD? AD is the perpendicular line drawn to BC. If it is perpendicular line drawn to BC, we can prove triangle ABD and triangle ACD are congruent triangles. Both of them are congruent triangles. If both triangles are congruent triangles, what about BD and CD? They are equal in lengths. First of all, I am going to write it BD equals DC. BD equals DC. But length of a side of this equilateral triangle is 2 cm. Therefore, BD equals half of 2 cm. Half of 2 cm, that's equal 1 cm. Now, BD equals 1 cm. We need the length of AD. What is AD? That is the perpendicular line drawn to BC from the vertex A. Right. Therefore, by using the right angle triangle ABD, we can write here AD squared equals AD squared minus BD squared. That is the usage of the Pythagoras relation. Then AD squared equals 2 squared minus 1 squared. Then AD squared equals 4 minus 1. After that there will be 3. Therefore AD equals root 3. Root 3 centimeters. Then the length of the perpendicular line drawn to BC from the vertex A is root 3. Express the answer as assert. Yes, root 3 is assert. Root 3 is assert. Is it an antiassert? Is it an antiassert? No. If it is an antiassert, that should be expressed as the product of rational number and irrational number. Actually, this number can't be separated into rational. We can't express this one as the product of rational number and irrational number. So root 3 is not an antiassert. That is only a cert. Root 3 is a cert. Then think about root 8. Root 8 is an antiassert. That is an antiassert. Why? That's why. Please divide 8 by 2. There will be 4. 4 is a number with real square. Then okay, root 8, that is an antiassert, no? Then that's equal root 4 times of 2. 8 can be written as the product of 4 and 2. 4 has a real square root that can be taken front of the radical symbol. Then that can be written as 2 root 2. 2 is a rational number, root 2 is an irrational number. That is the product of rational number and irrational number. If we can express some cert as the product of rational number and irrational number, such types of certs known as antiasserts. Now, okay. Fourth one. The location Q is reached from the location P. The location Q is reached from the location P on the horizontal ground by traveling 15 meters to the north from P and then 8 meters to the east. Rho is sketched based on the above information. Right. The starting point is P. Okay. Then, some person who travel to north direction from point P fifteen meters away from P. Then after that, turn to the east. Turn to the east from this point and travel, approach to the point Q by traveling 8 meter distance. This is the sketch. Find the distance PQ. A person who traveled 15 meters from point P to the north direction and turned to the direction east and traveled 8 meters distance up to Q. Then how to find the length of PQ? By using the Pythagoras relation, we can find the length of PQ. I think that is a shorter distance to the Q from P, or the linear distance to Q from P. PQ squared equals 15 squared plus 8 squared. Therefore, PQ squared equals 225 plus 8 squared is 64. 15 squared is 225 because 15 times of 15 is 225. Therefore, PQ squared equals 289. Then PQ squared equals root 289. 289 has a real square root. Therefore, PQ equals 17 meters. What is the linear distance from P to Q? That is 17 meters. That can be introduced as the shortest distance from P to Q. Both of them are correct. Right. Then here, let's focus to fifth one. Okay? Right. The lengths of the diagonals of a rhombus are 12 meter and 16 meter. There is a rhombus. Is it a parallelogram? Right. Decide whether it is a parallelogram or not. Then what about your idea about this one? About this plane figure. Now I am going to name this plane figure as ABCD. That is not given, huh? ABCD. What is ABCD? ABCD is a rhombus. Is it a parallelogram? Actually, definitely that is a parallelogram, because all the parallelograms can be divided into two, can be separated into two groups. What are they? Right parallelograms and oblique parallelograms. What are the right parallelograms? All the squares and rectangles, all the squares and rectangles included in the right parallelograms group or right parallelogram set. Then all the rhombuses and rhombus, the rhomboids, the rhombuses and rhomboids can be included in oblique parallelogram set. Therefore, any rhombus is a parallelogram. That is an oblique parallelogram. Then ABCD is an oblique parallelogram. But the special name of ABCD is rhombus. If it is a rhombus, you should know the properties of rhombuses. Do you know the properties of rhombuses? Yeah. All the sides are equal to each other if it is a rhombus. That is the main subject matter about rhombuses. If it is a rhombus, the all sides are equal to each other. That means AB equals BC equals CD equals AD. Okay, then are there any other properties actually? Definitely, there are other properties of rhombuses. AC and BD are two diagonals of this rhombus. They bisected by each other perpendicularly. That is very important subject matter. Then this angle is right angle. If ABCD is a right, ABCD is a rhombus, AC and BD two diagonals are bisected by each other perpendicularly at O. Then first one, what is the first property? All the sides are equal to each other. What is the second property? Two diagonals are bisected by each other perpendicularly. Are there any other properties of rhombuses? Yes. The angle of a vertex bisected by the diagonal. That means angle BAD bisected by AC. On the other hand, angle BCD bisected by the same diagonal AC. Angle ABC bisected by the diagonal BD. On the other hand, angle ADC bisected by the diagonal BD similarly. Okay? Then that is the third property of rhombuses. They are the special properties of rhombuses. If it is a normal parallelogram, all the sides are not equal, only opposite sides are equal. Everybody is a normal parallelogram. Two diagonals are bisected by each other, not perpendicularly. Right? If it is a normal parallelogram, the angles of the vertices not bisected by the diagonals. If it is only a rhombus, these properties can be seen. Right. Now, let's consider the name of this rhombus is ABCD. The lengths of the diagonals of a rhombus are 12 meters and 16 meters. Find the length of each side of the rhombus. Okay. If the length of AC is 16 centimeter, and if the length of diagonal BD is 12 centimeter, okay. Can you find the length of AO? Are there any relation between the diagonal AC and AO? Yes. If it is a parallelogram, two diagonals are bisected by each other. Then OA equals half of AC. That is half of AC. That can be written as half into 16 centimeters. That is 8 centimeter. Then length of AO is 8 centimeter. Then can you find the length of OB? Yes. OB and diagonal BD has a relationship. What is that relation? OB equals half of BD. Then half times of 12 centimeters, that's equal 8 centimeters. Then what about the type of the triangle AOB? If this angle is a right angle, AOB is a right angle triangle. Then the length of side OA and side OB are known. If two sides are given, we can find the length of the remaining side by using the Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, AB squared equals OA squared plus OB squared. The OA squared is 8 squared plus OB squared is 6 squared. Therefore, AB squared equals 64 plus 36. Then finally, there will be 100. Then AB squared equal 100. Therefore, AB equals square root of 100. Then finally, I can get the length for AB. Then AB equals 10 centimeter. If it is a rhombus, all the sides are equal to each other. Therefore, AB equals BC equals CD equals AD equals 10 centimeters. Okay. We have to find the length of each side. If one side is 10 centimeters, other sides also are 10 centimeters. Then final one. What is final one? I think that is very special one. That is known as, that is introduced as Archimedes spiral. You see here, the figure illustrates the special creation. That is very special creation. Archimedes spiral. What is the real name for this one? Archimedes spiral. By considering the right angle triangles in the figure, find the length of A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Using the given measurements. Now some measurements are given there. Express the answers in set form. Now there are so many right angle triangles. What about the smallest right angle triangle? The length of the sides contained in right angle are 1 centimeter. Now you see here. Then we have to find, we can find the length of A in the smallest right angle triangle. A squared equals 1 squared plus 1 squared. Therefore, A squared equals 1 plus 1. That's equal to. If A squared equals 2, therefore, A equals root 2. A equals root 2. Now, how to get the value for B? The second part. Then B squared equals 1 squared plus root 2 squared. 1 squared plus root 2 is solved. Because the length of A is root 2, already we have got E, the value of A. A equals root 2. Then we have expressed that value as a set. Then when getting the length of B, we can use the Pythagoras relation to the right second right angle triangle. Then B squared equals A squared plus 1 squared. A squared plus 1 squared. Then V squared equals 1 squared plus root 2 squared, because the length of A is root 2. The V squared equals 1 squared is 1 plus root 2 squared is 2. Therefore, V squared equals 3. Therefore, V equals root 3. Then length of A is root 2 centimeters. Length of B is root 3 centimeters. Both of them are expressed as sets. Now consider the length of, how to find the length of C? By considering the third right angle triangle, we can find the length of C. Then C is the hypotenuse of the third right angle triangle. Then C squared equals 1 squared plus B squared. Now I am going to write it. C squared equals 1 squared plus B squared. What is the length of B? The length of B is root 3, no? Then C squared is 1 plus root 3 squared, no? Do you know the value of root 3 squared? That is very easy. The easily can be obtained the value for root 3 squared. Therefore, C squared equal 1 plus 3. That is 4. This is the value for C squared. Not C. C squared. Therefore, C is equals to root 4. 4 is a real square. 4 is a number with real square root. Then, the square root of 4 is 2. Then, what is the length of C? 2 centimeter. Is it a cert? No. That is not a cert. Right. Now, when getting the length for D, you have to use the Pythagoras relation to the fourth right angle triangle. Actually, D squared equals 1 squared plus C squared. Then D squared equals 1 plus the C squared is 2 squared. Then D squared equals 1 plus 4. D squared equals 5. Therefore, D equals root 5 centimeters. Now, by using the same way, I think you can get the lengths of other three sides. What are they? E, F and D. Try to get the lengths of E, F and G by yourself. Now I am going to tell about further applications of Pythagoras theorem. As an example, please write this one on your exercise book. Okay, ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. And AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to AD. AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to DC. Please try this one. Obtain two relations for the right angle triangles. For the right angle triangles for the right angle triangles ABD and ACD respectively. Obtain two relations for the triangles ABD and ACD respectively. Respectively, kaha? Using the Pythagoras relation. Using the Pythagoras relation. Using the Pythagoras relation. Using the Pythagoras relation. Right. First of all, we have to write the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ABD because ABD is a right angle triangle. Then AB squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. Am I correct? Name this relationship as first one. On the other hand, we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACD. What is AC? AC is the arcadius of the right angle triangle ACD. Then here can be written AC squared equals AD squared plus CD squared. That consider this relationship as second one. Now if I need to remove AD squared, or if I need to eliminate AD squared from these two relations, then something has to be done for that. Which task has to be done to eliminate AD squared from these two relationships? By subtracting second one from first one, or first one from second one, second one from first one, or first one from second one, we can eliminate AD squared from these two relations. Now I am going to do it. The second, I am going to subtract second relationship from first one. The first one minus second one is okay. We can write the AB squared minus AB squared minus AC squared equals. Please write these two terms in a bracket. AD squared plus BD squared minus then AD squared plus CD squared. Then next step we can remove the brackets. Therefore AB squared minus AC squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. The minus when removing the brackets of this part, the signs of that two terms are changed. The plus AD squared change into minus AD squared, and plus AD squared change into minus AD squared. Am I correct? Now again, what happened? AD squared cancelled minus AD squared. They cancelled each other. Therefore, we can get new relationship. AB squared minus AC squared equals BD squared minus CD squared. Okay, now new relation has been obtained now. Right, okay. Now I am going to change this relationship to by taking minus CD squared to left side and by taking minus AC squared to right side. Therefore, AB squared plus CD squared equals BD squared plus AC squared. A new approach. This is a new approach, okay? I got this final approach by using these two relationships. We got that two relationships by using the Pythagoras relation to these two right angle triangles. Right, okay. Then we can focus our attention to exercise 17.2. Exercise 17.2. Right. Turn to the exercise 17.2. Okay, Exodus 17:2. Some figure is given there, and the statement is here. AD is perpendicular to BC in the triangle ABC. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. Then AD has been drawn to BC perpendicularly. Are there any other relation of AD and DC? The length of AD equals to length of DC. If AD equals DC, prove that AB squared equals BD squared plus DC squared. Yeah. To prove that, what is prove that? That is very important one. AB squared equals BD squared plus DC squared. Then, okay, we can approach the proof. Please use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ABD. After using the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ABD, here can be written AB squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. Name this relationship as first one. On the other hand, we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACD. Therefore, AC squared equals AD squared plus DC squared can be obtained here. Then that is our second relation. Now you have to compare these two relations with this step. Then AD squared is not here. The BD squared, DC squared, and only AD squared can be seen there. Right. Right, okay. Try to remove AD squared from these two relationships. By subtracting second one from first one or first one from second one, that can be done. Therefore, first one minus second one, AB squared minus AC squared equals AD squared plus BD squared minus AD squared plus DC squared. Therefore, AD squared minus AC squared equals AD squared plus BD squared minus AD squared minus DC squared. Right now here, another way is there. We can write here only this relationship: AB squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. But here AD equals DC, no? But AD equals DC, therefore AD squared equals DC squared. Then actually I know we can substitute DC squared instead AD squared of this relation. Therefore AB squared equals, you can write DC squared instead AD squared of this relation. Then I am going to write DC squared instead AD squared. Then DC squared plus BD squared. We can approach to the final relation very easily.
Don't use the Vaitika tessellation to that both triangles. We can use Vaitika relation only to the triangle ABD. That is enough. Then okay, here second one. What about second one? Already I have done it. Already I have done it as an example. Then I am going to focus my attention to third one. What is third one? AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC in the equilateral triangle ABC. What is ABC? ABC is an equilateral triangle. That is an equilateral triangle. If it is an equilateral triangle, each side is equal. All the sides are equal to each other. Then ABC. ABC is an equilateral triangle. Each side is equal. In the equilateral triangle ABC. Then here, AD is drawn to BC perpendicularly. AD. Right. Okay, then what is the proof that? What is that step? This is the important step. Prove that. To prove that. To prove that is 4AD squared. That's equal 3BC squared. To prove that is 4AD squared equals 3BC squared. Right, okay. First of all, we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ABD. Proof. By using the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ABD, that can be written as AB squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. AB squared equals AD squared plus BD squared. Right. Then are there any relation between BD and BC? Definitely. Because ABC is an equilateral triangle, then AD is perpendicular to BC, therefore ABD and ACD are congruent triangles, then BD equal to DC. Then what is the relation between BD and BC? BD equals half of BC. BD equals half of BC. If BD equals half of BC, BD squared equals half of BC squared. Then BD squared equal 1/4 of BC squared. That is the expansion of 1 over 2 BC squared. The expansion of 1 over 2 BC squared is 1/4 BC squared. Then finally, we can write 1/4 BC squared instead BD squared of this relation. Therefore, AB squared equals AD squared plus, please write 1/4 BC squared instead BD squared, 1/4 BC squared. 1/4 BC squared. Then all the terms have to be multiplied by 4. Finally, there will be 4AB squared equals 4AD squared plus BC squared. Right, BC squared, okay. Then, are there any relation between AB and BC? AB and BC. What is the type of the triangle ABC? That is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, AB, the length of AB equal to the length of BC. Length of AB equal to the length of BC. Therefore, we can substitute BC instead AB. Alright, but AB equals BC. Some reason is there. That reason should be written in brackets. Here also can be written some reason. What is that reason? What is the reason? What is the reason can be written front of the relationship according to Pythagoras theorem. please write them in brackets, according to the Pythagoras theorem, according to the Pythagoras theorem, right? Okay, here. Then another relationship is there. What is that relation? What is another reason is there? What is that reason? Sides of an equilateral triangle. Sides of an equilateral triangle. If AB equals BC, therefore AB squared equals BC squared. Actually, you can write BC squared instead AB squared. Now I am going to change this relationship. For substitute BC squared instead AB squared, 4BC squared equals AD squared plus BC squared. Now take BC squared to left side. Therefore, 4BC squared minus BC squared equals 4AD squared. When subtracting BC squared from 4BC squared, result will be 3BC squared equals 4AD squared. Now you can compare the final approach and this one. 4AD squared equals 3BC squared. Okay. Now already we have approached to that relationship. Therefore, 4AD squared equals 3BC squared. Then 4AD squared should be equal to 3BC squared. Okay. Now you can compare them. Now let's focus to fourth one. Fourth one, yes. AD is perpendicular to BC in the equilateral triangle ABC in the figure. ABC is an equilateral triangle. ABC is an equilateral triangle. So AB, AC and BC are equal to each other. Then AD is perpendicular to BC. This is the perpendicular line drawn to ABC. That the name of this perpendicular line is AD. AD is perpendicular to BC in the equilateral triangle ABC in the figure. BC has been produced to E. BC has been produced to E such that BC equals E. BC equals E. The sign BC has been produced to E such that BC equals E. Both of these line segments are equal. Then are there any relation between BD and DC? Definitely. Both of them are congruent triangles, therefore BD equals DC. Then BD, DC, CE are equal to each other. Then what is the relation between BD and BE? The 1/3 of BE equals BD. Then are there any relation between BC and BD? Yes. Then BD equals half of BC. BD equals half of BC. Right then, what is next one? Prove that. That's equal A squared equals 7 EC squared. A squared equal to 7 EC squared. Alright. You can start from A. How many right angle triangles of this figure? I think there are 3 right angle triangles. First one is ABD, the second one is ACD, the third one is ADE. In the triangle ADE, the opposite side to this right angle is AE. Then that is the hypotenuse of the triangle ADE. Now According to the system, I am going to use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ADE at first. Proof. What is the beginning of this one? We start from AE square, that's equal AD square plus DE square. Write here that reason. The reason is according to the Pythagoras theorem. Close the bracket. Then A square equals AD square plus DE square. Right? We can see the AD square and DE square of this relationship. Now we have to change that. How to do it? Okay. Are there any relation between DE square and BC square? Right? Observe the lengths of DE and BC. They are equal in lengths. Then I am going to write it. But DE equal to BC. According to the given information, we can write here DE equal BC. If DE equal BC, therefore DE square, that's equal BC square. Then I am going to write BC square. I am going to substitute BC square instead DE square of this relationship. Therefore, AE square equals AD square plus BC square. BC square, yes. Then okay. Now, use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACD. Use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACD. Therefore, AC squared equals CD squared plus CD squared according to the Pythagoras theorem. That is some reason. According to the Pythagoras theorem. Close the bracket. Then AC squared equals AD squared plus CD squared. Can you make AD squared as the subject of this relation? Definitely. Then AD squared equals AC squared minus CD squared. Therefore, AD squared equals AC squared minus CD squared. By taking the CD square to other side, we can obtain this relationship. Then AD square equals AC square minus CD square. Then okay, we can substitute the AC square minus CD square of this relationship and we can get new relationship. Therefore, AD square, that's equal AC squared minus CD squared plus BC squared. A squared equals AC squared minus CD squared plus BC squared. Because I substituted AC squared minus CD squared for AD squared of this relationship. Right. Then, are there any relationship between AC and BC? Yes, ABC is an equilateral triangle, therefore AC equals BC. Now I am going to write BC squared instead AC squared. Therefore, AD squared equals BC squared minus, now you see CD. Are there any relation between CD and EC? Yes. Both of them are equal in length because side BC is produced up to E such that DC equals CD. That is given. Then CD squared equal EC squared. That plus then BC squared. Are there any relation between BC squared and EC squared? Yes. The length of BC is equal to 2 times of EC. 2 times of EC. Then I am going to write here 2 times of EC instead. 2 times of EC instead BC. Right? Because BC equal DE. Then we can write 2 EC squared instead BC squared. Right? Here. AE squared equals again BC squared. The, what is the relation between BC squared and EC squared? Same. Then 2 EC squared. The 2 EC squared can be substituted instead BC squared minus EC squared plus 2 EC squared. Right. Get the expansion of them. Therefore, AE squared equals 4 EC squared minus EC squared plus 4 EC squared. Then when adding 4 EC squared to 4 EC squared, the result will be 8 EC squared. 8 EC squared minus EC squared is 7 EC squared. Therefore, AE squared equal to 7 EC squared. Now you can compare the final approach with this one. A squared equals 7 EC squared. Okay. Did you understand something? Yeah. Then okay. Right now. You can approach to the fifth one. The diagonals of the quadrilateral ABCD bisect each other perpendicularly at O. Prove that AB squared plus CD squared equals AD squared plus BC squared. Something has gone wrong here. Some fault is there. Did you identify that fault? That is not bisect, that is intersect. Because ABCD is a scalene quadrilateral. That is any quadrilateral. That is not a square. That is not given. That is not rectangle too. Then that is only an quadrilateral. Like this. There are two diagonals. They intersect. Not bisect. They intersect at O point O perpendicularly, that is okay, not bisect, intersect. Then what is the name of this one? A, B, C, D. That is the name of this quadrilateral. What is the main step to prove that? AB squared plus CD squared equals AD squared plus BC squared. Then AB squared here. AB squared plus CD squared. ABCD. CD squared equals AD squared plus BC squared. Then AB squared plus DC squared equals to AD squared plus BC squared. Right. The AB squared is here. Then if we need to get the AB squared, the relation for AB squared, use the Pythagoras relation to the right angle triangle AOB. That is the first step of this proof. AB squared equals AO squared plus OB squared. Is it correct? According to the Pythagoras theorem, That is completely correct. According to the Pythagoras, relation or Pythagoras theorem. Then on the other hand, we have to get the relation for CD squared. Then we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle DOC 2. Now DC squared equals DO squared plus OC squared. Same reason is there according to the Pythagoras theorem. Close the bracket. Then how to get the AB squared plus CD squared? By adding those relations, we can get it. Therefore, if it is first term, and if that second relation is second one can be added with two, second one. One can be added with, the first one can be added with second one. Therefore, AB squared plus DC squared equals A squared plus DO squared. AO squared plus DO squared, that can be written in bracket. Then plus OB squared can be added with OC squared. OB squared plus OC squared, that should be written in brackets too. Then therefore, AB squared plus DC squared. Now observe the given diagram. Do you know the result of AO squared plus DO squared? AOD is a right angle triangle. Then AD squared equals AO squared plus DO squared. Then we can write AD squared instead AO squared plus OD squared. Now I am going to write here AD squared instead AO squared and DO squared. Plus, then likewise observe the diagram. By observing the diagram, we can approach to final relation for OB squared plus OC squared. Then OBC is another right angle triangle. Then BC squared equal OB squared plus OC squared. That means BC squared can be written instead OB squared plus OC squared. Now I am going to write the ABC squared. Now I think this is our final approach. AB squared plus DC squared equals AD squared BC squared. You can compare this step with final approach. Right. Then okay, sixth one. O is a point within the rectangle right. O is a point within the triangle ABCD. ABCD is a rectangle. What is ABCD? That is a rectangle. If it is a rectangle, opposite sides are equal and angle of an vertex is 90. All of them are right angles and opposite sides are equal. What is the name of this rectangle? ABCD. What about the location of O? O is any point inside of rectangle ABCD. Let's consider. If it is the location of point O, then to prove that AO squared, then join AO plus CO squared, now join OC. BO squared AO squared plus EO squared equals BO squared is joined BO squared. The BO squared plus then what is the final one? DO squared. Please draw join OD, line OD. Then hint is there, draw parallel line through O to any side of ABCD. That is our construction. Construction is a hint is construction. What is that construction? Now we can draw a perpendicular, draw a parallel line to AD through O. This is the parallel line drawn to AD through O. They are parallel to each other. If it is a ABCD rectangle, if ABCD is a rectangle, AD, this line and BC are parallel to each other. Let's consider that line is XY. Then how to write the construction? Draw the line XY, draw the line XY through O. Such that parallel to AD. That's enough. Draw the line XY through O such that parallel to AD. Right away then. Here can be seen AO squared plus EO squared. Now first of all I would like to use the Pythagoras relation to the right angle triangle AOX. Is it a right angle triangle? Yes. Okay, that's why if these two pair of lines are parallel, they are the sum of them equals 180 degrees because both of them are allied angles. If one angle is 90 degrees, other angle is 90 degrees, that is also 90 degrees. Then AXYD is a small rectangle on the other hand, BXYZ is another rectangle. Now, I am going to approach to proof. Use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle OAX. Then, AO squared equals OX squared plus AX squared. Please name this relationship as first one. Now I think you can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle BOX. Therefore, BO squared equals OX squared plus BX squared. That is our second relationship. Now, we can subtract first one from second one, second one from first one. Now in this time I am going to subtract first one from second one. Now when subtracting first one from second one, please start from BO squared. Therefore, BO squared minus AO squared equals OX squared plus BX squared minus OX squared plus AX squared. Therefore, BO squared minus AO squared equals OX squared plus BX squared minus OX squared minus AX squared. Then OX squared cancelled minus OX squared. Then we can approach to new relation. BO squared minus AU squared equals BX squared minus AX squared. Please name this relationship as third one. Okay. Likewise, we can use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ODY because ODY is another right angle triangle.
then du squared, du squared equals oy squared plus dy squared. Name this relationship as fourth one. Then on the other hand, you can use the Pythagoras relation to the right angle triangle COY. COY. Therefore, CO squared equals OY squared plus CY squared. Name this relationship as fifth one. Now, in similarly, I am going to subtract fourth one from fifth one. When subtract in fourth one from fifth one, I can approach to another new relation. The fifth one minus fourth one. Therefore, CO squared minus DO squared equals to OY squared plus CY squared minus OY squared plus DY squared. Then here, therefore, CO squared minus DO squared equals OY squared plus CY squared minus OY squared minus DY squared. Then OY squared cancel to minus OY squared. After that, there will be another relation that can be named as sixth one. Therefore, CO squared minus DO squared equals CY squared minus DY squared. Okay. Name this one as sixth one. Right. What about third one and sixth one? The right side of third one is bx squared minus ax squared. The right side of sixth one is cy squared minus dy squared. Observe the diagram. Bx squared minus ax squared. Bx squared minus ax squared. Then here, cy squared minus yd squared. What about bx and cy? Bx and cy are equal because bxyc is a rectangle. If it is a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. Now I am going to write it. But bx equal cy and another relationship is there, ax equal dy. Ax equal dy. One relationship is there, what is? Opposite sides of rectangles. Rectangles. Both of them are rectangles. Okay, close the bracket. Then if bx equals cy, ax equals dy, therefore bx squared equals cy squared and ax squared equals dy squared. Is it correct? Yes. Then I am going to subtract this one from this one. Therefore, what happened? Therefore, bx squared minus ax squared equals cy squared minus dy squared. Now observe the right sides of these two relations. Bx squared minus ax squared, then cy squared minus dy squared. They are equal to each other. Therefore, left side of these two relations should be equal to each other. Therefore, bu squared minus a squared equals to co squared minus du squared. Now, can you get this relation by using this one? Actually, the minus AO squared and minus DO squared can be taken to opposite sides. By taking minus DO squared to the R and the minus AO squared to other side, I think we can get this new relation. Therefore, BO squared plus DO squared equals, please take this one to other side, AO squared plus CO squared. Now compare these two relations, the step of to prove that, and final approach. AO squared plus CO squared equals BO squared plus DO squared.
both of them are same. Finally, we can write there AO squared plus CO squared equals BO squared plus DO squared. Okay, did you understand? Yes. By use, please use the Pythagoras relation to some right angle triangles and try to obtain the obtain to the required. Right, I am going to focus my attention to not 7th one, only 8th one. Please do 7th one yourself. You can do 7th one yourself. That is your task. Then 8th one. First of all, we need to draw a diagram for this one. The two squares AB, XY and BC, BQ lie on the same side of the straight line ABC. What is ABC? ABC is a straight line. If it is A, if it is the location of B, let's consider this is the location of point C. These three points are lie on same straight line. They are A, B, C and D. Yeah. Then okay here, AB, XY and BC, BQ lie on the same side of the straight line ABC. Then what is AB, XY? That is a square. Now I am going to draw a square on AB. Let's consider this is a square drawn on side AB. The name of this square is AB, XY. On the other hand, another square is drawn on side BC, that is BC PQ. Then according to this diagram, the square of BC PQ is smaller than AB XY. Right. To prove that, PX squared plus CY squared equals 3 times of AB squared plus BC squared. I think that is very important proof. PX squared, join PX. CY squared, now join CY. Right. Both of them are squares, then angles of vertices are right angles. Here also same. Then PX, QO, PQX is a right angle triangle. The beginning of here, start from the side PX, use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle PQX. Then PX squared equal PQ squared plus QX squared. Right. PX squared equals PQ squared plus QX squared. Right. What is ABXY? That is a square. Then what is BCPQ? That is also a square too. Then if they are squares, side PQ and BC has a relation. What is it? PQ equals BC. Then if PQ equals BC, PQ squared equal BC squared. Now I can write BC squared instead PQ squared. Therefore, PX squared equals BC squared plus QX. Are there any relation between QX and BX and BQ? Absolutely, there is a relation between length QX, BX and BQ. When subtracting BQ from BX, we can get QX. Then QX equal BX minus BQ. Now I am going to substitute it, instead QX. Then what is QX? BX minus BQ. But QX, not only QX there. That is QX squared. Then get the square of BX minus BQ squared. Therefore,
Px squared equals Vc squared plus, this is a binomial expression, squared of a binomial expression. Can you get the expansion of this expression? What is the expansion? Yeah, get the square of Vx, that is Vx squared. Then after that, Vx has to be multiplied by with minus Vq. Then after that, there will be minus Vx Vq. The minus Vx Vq has to be multiplied by with 2 again. Then also will be 2 Vx times of Vq. Finally, get the minus Vq squared, that is plus Vq squared. Plus Vq squared. Now here, then are there any relation between Bx and AB? AB xy is a square, then AB equals Vx. That means Bx equals AB, then I can write AB squared instead Bx squared. Therefore, Px squared equals Bc squared plus AB squared minus the 2 times of Bx. The Bx equal AB, no? Then I can write there Bx equal AB. I can write here AB instead Bx. Times of BQ. Then are there any relation between BQ and BC? Yes. BC BQ is a square. Then BQ equals BC. Therefore, BC can be substituted instead BQ. Plus BQ square. What is the relation between BQ and BC? They are equal sides. Then BQ squared equal BC squared. Now, name this relationship as first one. Similarly, I am going to use the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACY. ACY. By using the Pythagoras relation to the triangle ACY, there can be obtained CY squared equals what? AY squared plus AC squared. Am I correct? Yeah. Then are there any relation between AY and AB? Because Vx, AB xy is a square, then AY equals to AB. Then there is a relation between AY and AB, they are equal in lengths. And AC. Yeah. Then AC is equal AB plus BC. I can write AB plus BC instead AC. Therefore, CY squared equals AY squared is AB squared plus, then AC squared, that is AB plus BC squared. Therefore, CY squared equals AB squared plus, get the square of AB plus BC is R. Then the, what is the expansion of this expression? That is AB squared plus 2 times of AB times of BC plus BC squared. Please name this one as second one. Right. If we need to get this relationship, please subtract second one from first one. Now I am Yes. Please add them all together. If we need to get this relationship, the first one has to be added with second one. First one has to be added to second one. After adding them, Px squared can be added with Cy squared. That result is Px squared plus Cy squared. Already we have got the left side of this step in here. Equals right. Now write this on. Bc squared plus Ab squared minus 2 times of AB times of BC plus BC squared has to be added with this one. AB squared plus AB squared plus 2 AB times of BC plus BC squared. Right. Now something happened in right side of this relationship. BC squared, BC squared, BC squared. They can be added all together. And on the other hand, AB squared,
AB squared and the CB squared can be added altogether. Therefore, AX squared plus EY squared equals 3AD squared plus, when adding BC squared to BC squared to again BC squared, result will be 3BC squared. Then what happened to these two relationships? Minus 2AB times of BC cancelled to plus 2AB times of BC. Then they are cancelled to each other. They are cancelled. Then this is the final position. PX squared plus CY squared equals 3AB squared plus 3BC squared. Now is it the final approach? Something has to be changed here. Therefore, BX squared plus CY squared equals 3 times of AB squared plus BC squared. That is our final approach. Now you can compare this one with this one. Okay, already I have discussed about applications of Pythagoras theorem further. Then after that, finally, I would like to give some idea about Pythagoras triples in next session. Then good night everybody and have a nice day. Thank you.